Welcome back to the biology lectures. Today under kingdom Animalia, we are going to discuss the phylum Echinodermata. Under this we are going to discuss the basic characteristics of echinoderms, as well as we will go through the water vascular system of Echinodermata. Let's begin with the basic characteristics that echinoderms possess, the features that echinoderms have. The first one, all are marine. All the echinoderms are marine except one, that is Synecta sibilis. This one is not marine. Except this, all the species under echinoderms are marine. They are found in the marine habitat. Secondly, they live mostly, all of them live at the bottom. Okay, if seawater is there, and they will not be found at the top of the water, they will be found at the bottom, and they are slow moving. They are not very fast moving species, they are a slow moving species. Third point, body shape is, various body shapes are found, like starfish. You remember, star like, cylindrical like, melon like, disc like, flower like. So many body shapes are there. Variety of body shapes is found in case of echinoderms. Fourth point is, body is unsegmented. No segmentation like in case of annelids and other phylums. Their body is bilateral symmetry in larva. Point to be noted here, bilateral symmetry in larva, but in adults the symmetry is radial pentamerous. So new feature is there, in larva they are found to have bilateral symmetry, but in adult radial pentamerous symmetry is found in case of Echinodermata. Echinoderms are triploblastic, and organ system of level of organization is found in case of echinoderms. They do not have head. They are not having a separate head or trunk type of body. They are having a one type of body only without any head. They are having 2 feet, podia. These are responsible for the locomotion, and these comes out through radial area, that is known as ambulacral. You can see here, it's a water vascular system of echinoderms, but here also you can see ring ambulacral vessels are here. So ambulacral vessel is here, 2 feet is this. This part is 2 feet part. So, once again, this is 2 feet, or you can say it is a 2 foot because I have shown you the one. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 2 feet are here, and you can say this is known as radial ambulacral vessel. This is known as radial ambulacral vessel, and from this comes out 2 feet. So 1 2 feet is here in presence of in front of you. 1 2 foot is here. It is having ampulla, podium, and sucker. So the 2 foot consists of ampulla, podium, and sucker. Next point is, body part consists of 3 things. That is the epidermis, the dermis, and the muscles. So epidermis is the single layer and ciliated layer. Next is the dermis. Dermis lies below the epidermis. It is quite thick and it has spines. Muscles. Muscles are smooth, and smooth type of muscles are here, and they are found below the dermis. So the body part consists of 3 layers. The epidermis, dermis, and muscles. Next is, echinoderms have true coelom. So cavity is true cavity, that is the true coelom, and it is lined by ciliated mesothelium. So ciliated mesothelium is lining the true coelom. Next point is, coelom is divided into many tubes and sinuses, which together form 3 systems. So the coelom, the true body cavity, is divided into many tubes and sinuses, many tubes which together a unique water-filled water vascular system or ambulacrum. The diagram is here for the water vascular system. Second, they form the hemal system. Third, they form the perihemal system. So this is the circulatory system. The type of circulatory system is hemal as well as perihemal in case of echinoderms. So let's have a look at the water vascular system, which is very important in case of echinoderm. So just go through this water vascular system. You can see here, we have to begin from the pores, from the metaporite. The water enters through this metaporite and it goes into the canal. From here, the water goes into the ring ambulacular vessel. Here the water is moving. The water will move into these ring ambulacral vessels. And from these ring ambulacral vessels, from these radial ambulacral vessels, the water will move into the tube foot, into the ampulla, podium and succus. So let's have a look at this. When water flows through this pores, through this metaporite, it will move into, imagine these are the ambulacral vessels. Imagine these fingers are ambulacral vessels. So water will move through the metaporite, and then what will happen? The tube foot will start having a motion like this, and then the body will move like this, like this. You have seen in case of starfish. So imagine my hand is a starfish and it is moving. So hydraulic type of system is here in case of echinoderms. So this is how the water vascular system works. Respiration takes place by many, by gills, by genital bursae, by tube feet. So many other types of respiratory systems are there as well. So respiration takes place, for example, I have taken three here. Gills in most like starfishes, genital bursae in brittle star, and tube feet in few. Most of them are having gills for the respiration. Digestive tract is complete except in case of brittle star. Brittle star is having incomplete digestive tract. Circulatory system, I have already told you the type of circulatory system. This is hemal and perihemal. They form the circulatory system in echinoderms. No excretory organ system. So the excretion is not through any organ, it is nitrogenous based, and it comes out through gills in most of the cases because they are having gills. Nervous system is simple and primitive. The echinoderms resemble chordates in early embryonic development. Very important point. If you are asked which type of phylum does echinoderms resemble in early embryonic development? So they are the chordates in early embryonic development. They have separate sexes. Fertilization is external, and they are having some types of larva. I have written five examples. Starfish, the larva is known as Diphenaria. Brittle star, the larva is known as Ophiocleuchus. Sea urchin, the larva is known as Ephinocleuteus. Sea cucumber, the larva is known as Auricularia. Feathered star, the larva is known as Dolichocephalaria. So this is all we have discussed about echinodermata. We have discussed the basic characteristics. We have also gone through the water vascular system, the hydraulic type of water vascular system in case of echinodermata. Thank you so much for being in the lecture.